Wisconsin Broadcasters Association Hall of Famer Bob Baird ruled Milwaukee's airwaves in the 60s and 70s. He spoke with countless musicians and celebrities over the years. Bob collected remarkable recordings of these encounters, which he's now sharing with the public. Here's Bob.
Who doesn't know who Bugs Bunny is, or Barney Rubble from the Flintstones, or Woody Woodpecker? These cartoon characters and many others were done by the man of a thousand voices, actor and radio personality Mel Blanc. I asked him how they coordinated the voice and the film, how they invented the characters, one of whom saved his life. We'll also find out who his favorite was and his connection with Six Flags Great America in Gurnee, Illinois.
And let's check in with Bugs Bunny. Bugs, you there?
Yep. What's up, Bob?
Mel Blanc is on the air with us, the man who makes the cartoons talk. And he, again, is going to be hosting, doing a host of cartoon voices. And all those characters come together for Warner Brothers in a full-length feature cartoon called Daffy Duck's movie, Fantastic Island. Now, did you have to watch the movie and then put the voices in? Is that the way that's done?
No, most people think it's that way, but that's not true. The voice is always done first, and they draw to the voice. It's a kind of odd thing. The animator will have the record of the voice, and then he has a desk and a mirror that he can look into. And they say that the character says, "Eh, what's up, Doc?" He will look in the mirror and say, "Eh," and then draw his mouth on the character. "Ooh, what's up, Doc?"
Speaking of "What's up, Doc?" and Bugs Bunny, I know that that particular character once saved your life. Could you tell us that story?
Yeah, I had a very bad accident. Oh, this was 1961. I was almost killed. In fact, I was so far gone, I was in the obituary column in Honolulu.
Jeez.
And I was unconscious for 21 days, and this brain specialist used to come in my room, I'm told, and he'd say, "How are you feeling today, Mel?" And I wouldn't answer him. Well, he got an idea, and my wife and son were there, and swear this is true. He came in one day, and he says, "Hey, Bugs Bunny, how are you?" And I answered him. I said, "Just fine, Doc. How are you?" So he turned to my wife and he said, "He's going to be all right. He'll come out of that unconsciousness," because he actually knew what I said to him. But after all, I don't remember saying that. And I know that I felt that I was dead, but my characters were still alive. So maybe I
Isn't that something?
Mind.
Do you find that those voices will just move into your everyday conversation after all these years? I mean, do you start talking like Bugs once in a while?
No, I don't unless somebody asks me about them. When I'm driving along, I'll see an animal, and I'll wonder how he talks. And say a hippopotamus, for example. I'll see a hippopotamus and wonder what he would say if he could speak. And I know he's big and he's heavy. And he's fat, and he's in the water all the time. That's the kind of voice I would give to him. So you see what you can do with the various animals.
Mel Blanc has created over 400 wonderful sounds and voices, including, of course, that unforgettable laugh of Woody Woodpecker. Is he around there, Mel?
Did that in 1937 for Walter Lantz.
And, of course, we get to see some of your characters over here at Great America.
Yeah, although I did all of the voices there.
Right, Yosemite Sam, of course.
Oh, yeah, Marriott's Great America is quite a thing. Everybody should see that park if they have a chance.
I think most people are under
it. Yosemite Sam is perhaps the toughest voice I do. His name was Yosemite Sam, real gravelly on the throat.
And the Roadrunner?
Meep, meep.
That's all he is.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, Foghorn. Here's one of my favorites. Foghorn Leghorn.
I say, pay attention. You say Foghorn Leghorn? Are you looking for chickens, Bob? Will you see that little house over there that says D-O-G? That spells chicken. Go get them, boy.
And a favorite cartoon, the Flintstones and Barney Rubble.
Oh, the guy that lives next door to Fred Flintstone, yeah?
Do you ever listen to the Jetsons?
Yes, right. I've seen the Jetsons already, sure.
Especially the boss on the Jetsons, the guy that says, "Jetson, you're fired!"
Do you have a favorite of all those voices?
Yeah.
I think the rabbit's my favorite, Doc.
That's good. I'm glad you said that.
And people would like to do what he does, but they don't have the crust enough to do it.
He's my favorite, really.
Continue doing those voices. You've made us so happy over the years with all those characters.
Thank you, Bob. And yeah. Porky Pig wants to say goodbye to you. Just a minute, I'll call him over. Porky, come here and say goodbye to him, will you?
Yeah, you but I will. So long, so long, so long, that's all, folks.
Bob Berry.
Thank you for listening to Bob Berry's Unearthed Interviews. Be sure to subscribe and rate our podcast on iTunes or wherever you find your podcasts. You can find all the episodes at WisconsinBroadcastingMuseum.org. Check out Bob Berry's book, Rock and Roll Radio Milwaukee. Book sale proceeds support Angels Kids Fund and Donate Life Wisconsin. The preceding program was made possible by a generous contribution from Terry Bond.